Investors have gotten very excited about changes they expect that a President Trump will bring to the market. But it's important not to put your snowplows out before the snow starts falling. I'm Jack Otter, editor of Barron's.com. I'm here with Scott Black, the founder of Delphi Management, a longtime Barron's Roundtable member, and of course a stock picker who looks into every nook and cranny of companies. Before we do that, let's get to your big picture view. You expect some growth, but nothing to break down the doors.
I think the United States economy as a whole, measured by real GDP, will grow somewhere between 2-2.5%, where I think Donald Trump is on the right track in lowering regulation, lowering corporate and personal income taxes. It will take a while to work through the system. If you look at the S&P earnings, normally they start out with much too high a prognostication. This year it calls for $130 over 108 and change, which would be a harbinger of 20% growth, which is unlikely. I'm being more realistic. I think it's around 13% growth to 123 in earnings. We place the market multiple here for forward growth to 123 in earnings. We place the market multiple here for forward at roughly an 18. As you well know, I follow a lot of small and mid-cap stocks that are out of the mainstream, but as a whole, the Russell 2000, Russell 2500 are both north of 20 times forward years to expected earnings. So it's a homogeneous risk class. Small and mid-cap stocks are very, very expensive.
So in this, of course, the old line is it's a stock picker's market, but we're going to go with that. Let's start with a tech company. You've certainly followed tech for a long time. You often find these smaller companies. Tell us about one.
There's a little company. It's called Fabrinet. Market cap's about $1.5 billion. The stock is in the mid-30s, and we think they're going to have over 30% growth this year. It's a June calendar year, so it would be $3.20 this year. Then growth slows a little bit to $3.60, so the mean would be $3.40. Now they have over $2.50 a share in excess cash, but we're honest. The way the Barron's is, we take out stock-based comp, which we think will be 40 or 50 cents a share. It puts it at an 11 multiple, earns 19% on book, and they're really dominant. I know there are companies like Flextronics and Sanmina, but they're not really good in the optical space. Their biggest customers are people like Oculus.
So what exactly do they make?
They package and manufacture things like lasers, optical switches, anything that has to do with, you know, optical fiber. A lot of it's datacom and a lot of it's telecom, but 77% of the whole company is really in optical fiber and related businesses.
And they're based overseas?
They're based overseas. They have a low tax rate, only 7%, because they're in Thailand. As I say, the company's got nothing but excess cash on the balance sheet. We expect them to earn between 19-20% on book this year, which is the same as a return on capital.
And now you have what I think of as a very un-Scott Black pick, but maybe it's a play on inflation going up, Freeport McMoRan?
Part of it, yes. If you look at the overall market, for the first time in a while, supply and demand are in balance. We're looking at a little over 16 million tons of production, 16 million tons of demand. Freeport McMoRan used to have oil properties. They divested them totally. They laid down $1.5 billion in stock in the last quarter. Ergo, that the debt equity ratio now is only 1.1 as we speak today. The company can earn close to $1.40 when you have $2.50 copper, which is where it is today. And they basically are in three good locations. They're in the United States, Latin America, and they have it's an excellent mine called Grasberg in Indonesia, which is upgrading the quality of the ore that's coming out. There'll be slight gains in production, but the company will do well in excess of 20% on book. They'll generate positive free cash, could continue to knock the debt down as the year progresses. So if somebody's willing to take a flyer, and it's a little more risky, I think it's reasonable. It's a 9.5 multiple on next year's expected earnings.
This stock, of course, has been hammered very hard in recent years. Do you actually see an uptick in copper demand, or you just think the price has gotten low enough that steady demand will keep this
company
going?
No, I think there's an uptick. Also, nobody can bring on a new mine at these prices, so there's a barrier to entry. And the other thing is, if you knew Freeport McMoRan, there was a man named Bob Moffat who ran the company. He was really an oil wildcatter. He's no longer associated with the company. Carl Icahn has two members on the board, and their number one priority was really to straighten out the balance sheet, which is what they've done.
Turnaround time. Thanks, Scott.
You're welcome.